Okay, and we're live. Good morning, dearest viewers. How do you do? How you doing, Fizzy?
I am tired.
Party too hard with the Halloweens?
I fell asleep at like 8 o'clock last night, man.
No. Hey, you can still go hard while going to bed at 8 o'clock.
I guess so.
Did you end up doing anything for Halloween? For the actual day of Halloween?
We watched a couple, like, spooky movies, but that was about it.
Ooh, what'd you watch?
Ooh, excuse me, we watched Nightmare Before Christmas, and then we watched the original Hocus Pocus.
Very nice. Have you seen the second one yet?
Sure have.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. What'd you think?
There's some parts of it that I really enjoyed, and some parts that I did not enjoy so much.
Interesting. And what didn't you enjoy, just out of curiosity?
I feel like I need to say what I did enjoy first, I guess. But
okay, you want to be positive first? That's fine.
Yeah. I need to figure out how to turn off my microphone in Destiny as well, because for some reason now it's like, hey, you can talk here and on Xbox. But anyway, so what I really enjoyed about the newest Hocus Pocus was I thought that the chemistry between the actresses that played the witches was like better even than it was in the original, which in the original was already really good. And so like that just made everything that they did in the line delivery and like the situations that they found themselves in the movie even funnier.
Yeah.
Like, so they were definitely for me like the highlight of the movie by and large. Because of that. Honestly, I feel like they were funnier in this one than they were in the original. But that was really fun to watch. And then I thought some of like the stuff they did with like the childhood scene with them was really good. Like, I thought like the child actresses that played them also were really good, which doesn't always happen. You know, I feel like child actors are kind of like a hit or miss. You know, either they're really good or they're really you know.
Yeah, no, I thought they did really good with conveying like the mannerisms of like, you know, the characters and everything. I was like, yeah, they picked really good like child actors for these characters. Like that was pretty cool.
Yeah, and I even thought like the townspeople were fairly well done as well. So that was like a nice little like prequel scene and stuff like that. I'm trying to think if there's like anything else that like comes to mind. But like negative stuff, I guess. So like I felt that like the main three characters, so like if you go back to like the present day, the main three characters were kind of I thought the main three characters were kind of like misused a little bit. So like the main characters, like the main girl that was like got the powers and all that stuff like that, honestly thought she was not that great. Like she was pretty dead. I thought that they could have probably switched that role with her and the other girl that had the girl that had glasses. I forget what her name was.
Mm-hmm.
The curly hair glasses, because she that actress just seemed like she was way more in it and way more like better on like way better on screen than the other girl was. And then the third girl, they kind of just like, oh yeah, she's here.
Yeah.
And so like you never really got to know her, so it was kind of like okay.
Yeah, we had like almost zero information about her besides like, oh yeah, she's the mayor's daughter.
Yeah, like we got no character development from her at all. Like I barely remember what she looks like because that's how like I feel like how little screen time she got just on her own, you know? So
Yeah.
like even like not even just like on her own, but like where the camera like specifically focused on her face. Kind of weird. And then like the I don't even remember his name, but the guy that runs the magic shop. Okay.
Yeah.
This is the biggest deal for me, okay? Because either that guy is the stupidest man alive, or he needs to be in jail.
Yeah.
Because where in his freaking head did he think that, first of all, it would be a good idea to resurrect evil witches for no good reason besides they're my heroes? And then that even brings up something else. Why are these evil witches your heroes? But then the other thing is that not only did he resurrect evil witches, but he made like miners do it for him, like specifically endangering them, knowing that these witches needed miners to replenish their like age and beauty. So basically he's gonna sacrifice these people that he thought were her, that I like he seemed to think that were his friends just for his like own curiosity. And then of course those witches proceed to go and hurt people and destroy property and you know do all these things, and at the end of the movie like nothing happens. Like
Yeah, like
he doesn't get punished at all. Nobody is like, wow, you did a bad thing. They kind of just like the girls are kind of like, wow, I can't believe you made us do that. And he's like, oh, I'm so sorry. And like, it's okay, you big dummy. And then that's it. And it's like, no, either he's the stupidest friggin' man alive, or he is super malicious. And either way, he should probably not be not punished for this. This is not okay.
Yeah, no, for sure. Like it was I don't even know. Just really weird more than anything. Just like okay, so like do we just not have the runtime to really resolve this and you don't want to make him like a super bad guy either?
Yeah, well the funny thing is like honestly I feel like they could have had the runtime if they didn't do the weird ending with the Sanderson sisters that they did.
Yeah.
That was a little weird for me too because it kind of seemed like all of a sudden they were like, we're evil, we're gonna do our thing, we're gonna do our thing. And then like, I could kind of see like the ending coming a little bit, but then the way that they executed the ending was just like, oh my gosh, we get it. Like we get it, y'all really want to put Bette Midler on center focus here, but like this scene is just going on for way too long. But
Yeah. Well, like that's another thing. I'm like, you do realize that these witches like eat children, right? Like
yeah.
they're not really misunderstood, like they just care about themselves, and it just kind of like felt like, oh, everybody gets a happy ending, and I'm like do you remember the first one where, you know, there's a guy dressed up as the devil, and they're all like, oh, Satan, he's here.
Or like, do you remember the first one where they actually like killed a little girl? You know,
Yeah.
like they actually killed a little girl. Like they killed Zachary Binks's little sister on screen. Like, come on. You know?
Yeah.
Like they are legitimately murderers, you know?
Yeah, no, like. That's what I meant when like I was like it doesn't follow the lore because it's like in that universe witches are evil by, you know, killing children and like doing like the dark arts kind of stuff. And I thought that it was kind of weird that they kind of mixed in, you know, the girl being like a witch and stuff. It was kind of like, oh, aren't witches evil in this universe?
Right. Yeah, and that's where it was kind of like that's where it was kind of confusing with the like the elder witch or whatever, you know, that they met when they were kids. Where it
Yeah.
was kind of like, okay, I have like I'm fine with this, but I have so many questions.
Yeah.
Like, where did she go? Is she still alive? Like, are we gonna have a Hocus Pocus 3? Like, who knows? You know, it's so many
Yeah.
questions.
Well, if this one made enough money, then yeah, we will have a Hocus Pocus 3. Oh, sorry, Fire Squatch. For some reason, the stream isn't showing the information that I put in. So we're playing Destiny 2, not Halo. But yeah. Sorry, Fizzy.
Oh, for what? I don't
I kind of went off on something else instead of staying on topic. But
Wow, how dare you talk to a viewer? How dare you talk to one of your moderators?
oh my gosh.
Oh
But
my gosh.
yeah, no, like once again, it's a fun movie to watch, but like if you think about it in context of the movies, then it's kind of like this doesn't make a lot of sense.
Yeah, like honestly, I would watch it. I would probably watch it again, but I honestly would like almost be tempted to skip through some of the non-Sanderson sisters scenes. It's because like honestly, like they don't really mean anything. Like honestly, they
Yeah.
really don't contribute to the story very much, so it's kind of just like, eh, you know. One thing I did miss too is that whoever wrote the script for the first one, like they kind of had like a they had a really sarcastic sense of humor,
Yeah.
and I kind of miss that a little bit. I feel like the humor was like a little was made like a little like, oh, we gotta be nice in this one. But I guess it's the
Yeah.
difference between a movie that was made like in 1993 versus, you know, 2022. So which
Yeah,
is
it was a
crazy
little.
that far apart, man. It's kind of wild.
It is. Like, more than anything, if the newest one felt a little more slapstick, funny.
Yeah.
Oh, Fire Squash. Yeah, Halo World, the World of Warcraft. Sure, yeah. Joke. What?
Yes, every time I boot up Destiny Firewatch, I immediately get Cheeto stains on my fingers and three empty cans of Monster populate around my screen.
You might want to get that checked out.
I'm making a World of Warcraft joke, gosh.
Yeah, so that is our small review on Hocus Pocus. Yeah, I hope that everybody had a good Halloween. I basically had like a whole entire weekend devoted to Halloween, where I went over to my parents' house, we ate tons of junk food, watched Hush and
Classic.
Scary Movies to Tell in the Dark. Crap, what else did we do? We did some Halloween trivia, spooky movies and stuff like that. Good times. Then Sunday was D&D that kind of had like a horror theme to it. So I had to. Well, for those of you that have Instagram, I was tagged in it by Corndog Isha. I had to do like running blood from my eyes, and I did that twice. And man, that kind of really gets to you at certain points of the day.
Oof.
But yeah, that, and then for actual Halloween, we played a couple rounds of Fortnite and watched The Witch's Ghost, Scooby-Doo The Witch's Ghost, a classic, you know?
Dude, sounds like you had a freaking fun-packed weekend, my man.
Yeah, man. It was a freaking good time. Did you do anything fun over the weekend as well?
Not really. It was a pretty boring weekend, I'm not gonna
Well,
lie.
hello, Corndog Isha.
I will say, I think I guess I didn't realize this about you until this weekend, but like, I don't think anybody goes as hard on Halloween as you do, man.
Oh,
Yeah, like honestly, like I was like, oh yeah, I like Halloween marginally, but then I'm like, oh my gosh, freaking Unscathed loves Halloween. And that's cool, man. That's cool.
thanks, man. Oh, and I miss you too, Fire Squatch. Should have come up. We would have had tons of fun.
You gotta call him by what he called you. No, I'm just kidding.
Baby?
Baby. Baby. Baby
Yeah.
fire.
No, dude, like, I mean, I've really gotten into more of, like, dressing up and really, like, putting more into Halloween. So, like, I'm here for it. I mean, I've also done, like, fanics and stuff like that and tried my best to put together costumes. So, like, I mean, Halloween's like my jam. So, yeah. And it really feels weird with us going into November because it's like, okay, so like that's away. And now I need to worry about like Thanksgiving and like start buying like Christmas presents and stuff like that, which just feels weird at this point.
Yeah, it's a pretty crazy, it's a pretty not a crazy transition, but it's like it's kind of like a it could be a little jarring sometimes, yeah.
Yeah. But yeah. But what'd you end up doing for Halloween? I know we talked a little bit off stream, but I don't think we talked about it on stream.
You're talking to me?
Yeah.
Didn't I already tell you? Because
Yeah.
we literally just talked about it.
But
On
wasn't
stream.
that before we. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I don't know. I'm tired. Let's get into playing some games.
was like, Zach, I haven't talked to you in like 3 days. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh my
So
gosh.
confused. I was like, what?
Be confused, Fizzy. Let's see here. Let's get into a little bit of Crucible funness.
A crucible.
Crucible.
Oh, man.
Yeah, man.
Crucible just feels bad to me now.
What's
The
that,
word
sorry?
crucible. God, I have all the sugar and I was coming off the high. Yeah, I think so. I
Yeah.
think you're right.
No, dude. Freaking for sure. Like, my parents gave us, like, a box of donuts. And, like, I had one for breakfast. And, like, I haven't had, like, a donut for breakfast in a long time. And I was like, I feel like crap. I am not doing this anymore.
Bro, you're getting old.
Yeah,
You're getting old, man.
man.
Just
No.
comes a point, dude, where it's just like, man, like, I could either feel good and eat something that's not as fun, or I could feel terrible and eat this. Bro,
Yeah. No,
yeah.
dude, we actually had to throw some stuff away because I'm just like, I can't do it.
No, we were over at somebody's, we were over somebody's place like Saturday night watching some football, and they had some candy, and I tried to eat like an atomic warhead for the first time in a little while. And I used to do
Yeah.
this all the time, and like, oh my gosh, it wrecked me. Like, it was fine, like eating it was fine, but like once I had like swallowed it, I had such a bad stomach ache for the rest of the night. I was like, oh jeez, I used to eat these all the time, and now my old 28-year-old stomach just can't handle it anymore. I'm getting weak. I'm getting
Getting
feeble in my old
weak.
age.
Ah, dude, it's such a thing, but oh, it's over. I'm gonna go through kind of a detox until we get to freaking Thanksgiving, where like you stuff your face.
Gotta drink a lot of water, man. You gotta stretch out that stomach.
Yeah, exactly.
It's so bad.
So bad. Man.
I think I'm actually really excited for Thanksgiving, and it's for like a really simple and sort of dumb reason. Really
Oh,
excited for
yeah.
Thanksgiving because I keep seeing amazing, I don't know if like Facebook and Instagram has just decided that I love mac and cheese more than anything else. But I keep seeing like really amazing recipes for like mac and cheese you can take to your family on Thanksgiving, and like, oh my gosh, like, oh my gosh, like, bro, they look so good. So I'm gonna make some freaking bomb mac and cheese, and I don't know, it's just got me hyped for the whole holiday just for that thing alone.
Yeah, man. That's awesome. Like, is it going to be like mixed with something or just like a very particular mac and cheese kind of deal?
Well, apparently the secret ingredient or the secret weapon with mac and cheese is putting bacon in it. So, I mean, I do love bacon, so I'm cool with it. I
Yeah.
do be having mac and cheese dreams. I legitimately dreamt about mac and cheese on Sunday night. Like, I remember waking up at like 3 in the morning and be like, "Bro, I'm hungry right now. I need some mac and cheese."
Gotta get that mac and cheese.
Ugh. Dude, I could imagine, man. I could not work in food. I would get so fat. Like,
No, dude,
legit.
everything that she brings me home, I'm just like, oh, this is so freaking delicious. It's actually kind of funny the other night, like going back to kind of like the sugar and the mac and cheese thing, like we were kind of sitting there, we had like Rice Krispie treats and like a couple other like candies and stuff like that. And I'm like, I want to eat this because, you know, it's Halloween and you got to eat it. But at the same time, I'm like, I just want something savory.
Take
Like,
those
I
soldiers
don't
out.
even know what.
Victory demands it.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Enemy claimed Zone C. Zone B captured.
Yeah, dude, you would have
Tactical
loved these
advantage.
Rice
You have
Krispies.
zone
Like,
one.
they were so freaking good. Homemade, and then also on top of that, they had Halloween sprinkles in them, so we got that extra little flair. Yeah, top tier.
You captured Zone C. That's a power play. You took them. Now hold them. Zone B lost.
Sorry, I'm chasing somebody. I'm gonna be quiet for a second. Ah, oh, dang it.
Oh, dang. Need some more heavy ammo. Zone C lost. Enemy has
Oh, I've
won.
also been playing
Zone
the
B
Modern
captured. Zone
Warfare
advantage
campaign.
secured.
I've been bumming it off of my brother. And it's pretty good. Not gonna lie. Like, there's a couple of things that are kind of questionable. Like, just in the very aspect of, like, in real life, could you actually do this, though?
taking some points for realism, eh?
Yeah.
You captured Zone
And
C.
I know that Call of Duty is not really about
You
that
took
war
them.
that
Now hold them.
realism, but I'm just like kind of sitting there like it kind of takes me out a little bit, just like, could you really have like a AC-130 in the air giving you support in a space that is not war?
That's a good point. Honestly,
Zone
that's
C
surprising
lost.
to me because I'm like, you know, I would feel like a game like that should be more realistic than not.
Yeah.
So it's a shame
No,
that it's not.
like I'm totally fine with, you know, a little bit of that,
Zone C captured. Power play.
you
Keep the
know,
pressure
being
on.
like over the top because it's very much like kind of like more of an action kind of movie is the feel of it that I have.
Sure.
But at the same time, I'm like, shouldn't you at least try a little bit? Brown the butter before adding the marshmallows? Huh. That actually does sound delicious. I'm here for it, dude. I need to try that next time. Oh, you're not my friend. Milsim? Caught as an arcade shooter. Yeah, true. I know it's an arcade shooter and everything. It's just... But once again, they try to kind of tote a little bit more realism. I know that Battlefield's one of those that kind of goes a little bit harder than, Oh, that shotgun sucks.
Yeah, I've heard Tarkov is really good for that.
Yeah. No, I know that there's, like, other games that are way better. Zone A captured. You have advantage. Oh, my grenade didn't do anything. What the heck? Isn't Tarkov only on PC, though? You
have advantage. That I don't know.
Because, like, I've been wanting to give it a go. I know that it'll probably be frustrating for me, since all I do is play arcade shooters. Oh, crap. There's a lot of explosions. Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, and still waiting on some more Halo news. Like, it's been really weird. I don't know if you've been keeping up with the Halo post, Fizzy, but basically, like, they have been, like, posting, like, essentially it feels like these Instagram reels that, like, are giving, like, more information about the... winter update, but they're not, they really don't give that much.
No, they've been pretty like mum on it. Actually, it's been like,
yeah,
it's been kind of frustrating. Kind of like, you know, you guys are reaching this vaunted winter update,
yeah,
pretty soon, and like we really don't have that much information about it, you know.
Yeah,
but oh well. Oh hello. Oh my gosh.
Oh crap. Yeah, man, I know they're probably just trying not to hype it too much like they have been doing, but it's still like, hey, can we get a little bit more information, you know?
Yeah, seriously.
Especially since it's coming out, like, what is it, next week?
Yeah.
Oh, that's not the same guy I was shooting at.
Strengthen numbers, Guardian. Excellent. Yeah, that's probably true, honestly, Fire Sponge. 3 minutes. You're winning.
Stay strong. That's true, yeah.
Oh.
And I really do hope that they over deliver.
Yeah, like, honestly, hopefully this freaking winter bay is gonna be hype AF.
Yeah. I mean, we'll see. I'm glad to actually have something else to work towards. And from what it sounds like, oh my gosh. Like, it seems like they're reevaluating like the challenge system to make it so you can actually play what you want. You don't have to play specific matches or anything like that.
Which is so good. Like, honestly, like that alone, I'm happy about. Like, oh my god, just trying to grind to get some of this stuff has been insane.
Victory well executed. I got a freaking auto rifle that's gold. What the heck? Control. Targets eliminated. Nice work. So, do you just want to keep playing some more Crucible, or what would you like to do?
That's up to you, fire team leader.
Okay. We'll play another one and maybe we'll do like a Vanguard mission or something. I've been trying to figure out if there's some type of like campaign thing that we could play, but I think everything's with the newest expansions. So, we'll see what happens, but for right now, we'll just be playing a couple of things of what the Destiny has to offer.
Destiny.
Destiny. But yeah, man, like, I really do hope that there is, that everything goes well. Because I really expected them to kind of just, you know, push the armor a little bit more, but, like, haven't really seen anything. Like, the only videos that they've been doing recently are the different, like, achievements from the like co-op gameplay stuff, which is, I mean, it's fine. It's just kind of like you gave out descriptions of these already, like you don't really need to make videos on them.
Yeah, I think for me the number one thing that I'm wanting them to do, like the winter update, like there's a few other things I know they're doing which are gonna be cool, but like for me, like I care probably a little too much about the cosmetics, so I really want them to unlock the rest of the Mark 5B, like the reach armors and stuff like that. You know, like I hope they don't put any of them behind like a paywall or like an event, well not like an event wall, but like a weekly ultimate or whatever, you know, like I just want them all to be able to be unlocked in that event that they do. But we'll see how that goes. But
No, the only other thing that I've really heard about that is apparently I think it was on Twitter or something, because that's usually where you get like just the weird off the wall information, is that the pass, the winter update pass, is going to be just like the other battle passes, where they are constantly unlocked, so you can go back and you know, change between the different passes. So at least that's good news.
Yeah, they're kind of taking a step back in some regards too, because I know a lot of PC players, myself included, have been having some problems with system stability now all of a sudden.
Really?
Yeah, like I can't even keep the game booted for longer than like 10 minutes.
What? So you haven't been able to play like at all?
Yeah, I've tried playing like a couple times this weekend and yeah, nothing. And at all.
Oh my gosh. That's ridiculous, my dude.
Yeah, it's been dumb.
Yeah, I've been noticing that you've been playing a lot of like different games when I've seen you on. Has that mostly been why?
Partially, yeah. Because I really wanted to get this week's challenge, but I couldn't, and so I've been doing other stuff instead.
What is the weekly reward?
It was like that Scarlet Visor that was really cool.
Oh.
It was just like a little cosmetic, basically.
I gotcha. Nah, man,
Oh.
I've been really bad about getting the weekly rewards.
No, you honestly haven't been missing that much. Some of the, like, most of the weekly rewards recently
Oh.
have not been that great, and that's why I really wanted to get this one, because I was like, oh man, finally a good one.
Yeah. Like, don't get me wrong, like, I'm glad that they haven't been just, like, you know, emblems and stuff like that, like they used to be. But
Yeah.
it's still not that good either.
Oh, yeah, that wasn't gonna work.
But yeah, I'm looking forward to being able to set my, holy crap, what the heck? My character up like I did back in the Reach days. The Mark V helmet and get out of here, clockwork. Man, I feel like I have to use more brain power for this.
Don't be lost. They have advantage.
And I also do kind of hope that we get to the point where Halo kind of gets a little bit more silly with their cosmetics as well. Because that's kind of one thing that I've kind of appreciated about Modern Warfare 2 as well as the kind of odd skins that you can get. Like the other day I was like going through and looking at the skins that they offered by like different promotional materials. Like for instance, one of them is they have one with Burger King where it's like a dude with like a handlebar mustache and like a burger hat and stuff like that.
Nice.
Yeah, and then Jerky did one with them as well. So it's a ghillie suit that's like made out of jerky.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. I know that somebody went through some of the files and found that there's like a snowman helmet that was supposed to re release like last year, or it was in the files. So I'm kind of hoping that will come with the winter update as well.
Yeah, we'll see.
Enemy has advantage.
I feel like I'm really getting the hang of this now. How you feeling, Fizzy?
This match isn't as good as last match. I was doing really good last match, but I could have been screwing around too, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
Oh, dang it. Oh, jeez, they're all right
Yeah.
there. Okay.
I'm just feeling a lot better with the gunplay and what I need to do. I'm not feeling like, oh my gosh, like my gun just feels like it doesn't work.
Yeah, I feel you. I feel like I needed to switch my. I need to switch weapons in between this match and next if we do one.
Okay.
It's my my.
You've
Baby, we're not
captured
trying to
Zone
text
B.
chat.
You have
What's
advantage.
that?
Fizzy
What can
Jr. is
stop you?
sitting here with me, and
I
he
fear
really likes my
nothing.
keyboard because it lights up.
Nothing is
I think that's pretty dope.
Yeah.
I'd probably be playing with it too. Like, hey Fizzy, can I just touch the keyboard while you're playing?
Can I just touch you?
It
That's funny.
probably makes fun clickety-clack sounds too.
Kind of. It's not a mechanical keyboard, so it doesn't do too much clickety-clackety. Oh, I don't know why I thought I could go up against him. He has better reach.
Hey, always believe, Fizzy.
Always believe.
Never give up on yourself.
Turns up the assist.
What?
Oh, Fire Squad just talking smack in the chat.
Turns up aim assist? What the heck? Dude, I'm not gonna lie. I've debated just like turning it off because sometimes it messes me up really bad.
Zone A captured. Zone advantage is yours.
Like, I do understand that like aim assist like helps with like controller, but dude, sometimes it's just like I've noticed it in Fortnite more than often. It is like I'll be shooting at somebody and the aim assist will stick a little bit with, like, for instance, if there's two people next to each other and they're like moving in between each other, it'll sometimes like move my cursor a little bit more towards the other guy that moves in front and track them. And I'm just like, no, I'm shooting at the other guy. Don't do that.
No, I feel you. It's kind of weird because it's like, yeah, it doesn't always work really good. It's on PC, it like doesn't do anything basically, but.
Mm-hmm.
I just love this rifle. I know it's not my strongest one, but I just love this one.
What's that, sorry?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just talking about the gear that I have.
What's your gear like, Fizzy?
Well, I got this scout rifle a while ago when we were playing. I think it was like 2 or 3 playthroughs ago. And like, It's not my strongest rifle, but I just love the way it handles and the fact that it shoots explosive rounds.
Yeah.
So I keep going back to it, even though it's not my best, and I'm like, but I just love it so much.
We're so good.
We're so good. I just love it so much.
I'm sorry.
Is that right? Can you say ba? Ba ba ba.
Ba.
Ba ba ba. We'll continue to claw at the walls of our city. It just squeezes you. Beneath the ruins of
a cosmic room, in the shadow of an old colony. That's a lot of text right there.
I know. Y'all couldn't have, like, just split the subtitles up a little bit? Come
nope.
on, Bungie. Well, the guy looks like he has, like, an X-Wing. That's dope.
That is really dope.
Like an X-Wing.
Speaking of Star Wars, I still have not watched Andor.
Oh, bro, you're missing out. It's really good. I haven't watched the whole thing yet, and I can tell you it's really good.
Really good?
It's real good. Okay, so basically we're just killing the ever-loving heck out of people.
Yeah. Exactly.
Alright, sounds good.
Murder everything in your path, Fizzy.
I can hand fight. Whew, excuse me.
I feel like there's other TV shows and stuff that I need to get caught up on too, but I can't remember what they are.
Well, if you don't remember, I sure don't remember.
Yeah, it's fine.
Oh, I mean, you. Okay.
Oh, I need to go through and change all my stuff back. I still have all my shaders and stuff for more of the, Halloween stuff. I just barely went through and changed my hunter skin to have, like some blue winter stuff.
Oh, it's okay, man. It's Halloween somewhere.
It's Halloween somewhere. I don't think that's how that works, Fizzy.
It should work okay.
Yeah, so I think
That's
we're one of the last ones, right? Everybody else is before us.
Oh, like time zone wise? I don't know.
Yeah. There we go, my grenade actually did something. So, random quiz. Question for you, Fizzy. Have you played Fallout 76?
I have not.
Okay.
That's the only Fallout title I have not played, believe it or not.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I remember playing it when it first came out. I was like, this is so buggy.
Yeah, I mean it's a Bethesda game on release, like
Yeah.
No, I haven't really gotten into it just because it's more of like an MMORPG, and I don't
Yeah.
have like I've heard people have really positive experiences within stuff. Like, don't get me wrong, I just as soon as I hear the words MMORPG, I'm like, well, I immediately don't have time for
Yeah.
that, you know. So, like, I haven't played, like, I really love Elder Scrolls as well, which is another Elder Scrolls title or Bethesda title. But
Yeah.
again, it's like Elder Scrolls Online is kind of like MMORPG kind of a thing. And like, yeah, again, like as soon as I hear those words, I'm like, eh, I don't really have time for that. So
Yeah. Yeah, no, I totally
I
get what
thought
you
of
mean.
playing a little bit of it when they did the Brotherhood of Steel like free weekend, but
Yeah.
oh, that was about it.
I gotcha. I'm coming, Fizzy.
Hey, no worries. I had the misfortune of standing right where all the bad people spawned. So
Oh crap. Bad idea, bad idea. I thought I had enough.
Raven's got me.
Oh. Dang it. Yeah, man, like I've been really wanting to get into playing Skyrim and stuff like that. But like you said, it just takes so much time.
Well, at least Skyrim you can like pick up and put down whenever you want, which is
Yeah.
kind of the nice thing. Like, the thing with MMORPGs is that like they take time, but you can't you oh my gosh, you really can't pick them up and put them down, you know? Like, I mean, it's like you gotta play events, or like you gotta play events, you gotta play like all that stuff, and if you don't, like, you legitimately
Yeah.
are missing out. It's not like, oh, I didn't play this Fortnite event, so it's no big deal. It's kind of like you will legit like miss out. So,
Fizzy, I need to
anyway.
get that spray though.
Yeah, Yeah, it's just, yeah. So, I don't know. I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, I probably will play it one day just because I love Fallout probably more than most video game franchises, but
Yeah.
I just haven't got around to it yet.
I gotcha. Yeah, no, like, I've been wondering if it's one of those, like, comeback games, but I haven't really heard anything about it.
Yeah, I mean the launch of Fallout 76 was hot garbage. I mean it was probably one of the worst video game launches in video game history.
Yeah.
So there's that.
Yeah. And
Yeah,
I.
it was just god awful. I mean Bethesda just like
Learn
made
something here.
so many promises that were like
Just on the other side of the
unattainable
Falls.
and like straight up not true. Like it was just not a good time. But
Yeah.
I guess they've somewhat recovered since then, so no big deal.
Am I a freaking Halo Jedi? Yes. But yeah, man, like, I don't know. I've been trying to make sure that my gaming tastes like expand a little bit. And it's kind of funny, like, being a person that hasn't played a lot of games. Because there'll be like certain times when I'm like, I had a lot of fun playing, you know, Fallout 4, whereas people are like, what are you talking about? You need to go and play New Vegas and that sort of kind of stuff. And
Oh man, don't get me wrong, man. New Vegas is fun, but New Vegas fans are like the most toxic people in the Fallout franchise. Like New Vegas fans sometimes can be like those kind of fans that are like,
Oh, holy
only
crap.
New Vegas is good. Like only New Vegas is the good
Yeah.
game. And it's like, that's not true, guys. Like they all just
Yeah.
insist, like they're like, it's the only good Fallout game, like any other game is just horse crap.
Yeah,
Like, okay, whatever. Yes, New Vegas is good. You should definitely give that a shot. But it's definitely just take that as you will, I guess.
no, I gotcha. I mean, I kind of had the same experience with it when, with Battlefield, because I know that a lot of people are like, you know, Battlefield 2042 is trash. The only good maps are maps that were remade. And
Yeah,
I'm all like,
honestly,
since
I
I've
feel like
never
I've felt
been.
that way with video games in general. It's like there's definitely some video games that are hot garbage, but like you kind of have to like experience them for yourself before I feel like you can really make a good.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because like there's people who will legitimately tell you that like good video games are terrible, and it's like they're actually pretty good. Like I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah. Yeah. And like, I mean, with Battlefield like 2042, the reason that I like it is because I can play it very much like I don't have to really pay attention to it. You know, with like certain, you know, games like Call of Duty and stuff, where you're like, okay, so I have to put on this attachment in order to make this better, and I need to figure out which one's the best, and which one's the best for my play style.
This is
With
the best.
Battlefield 2042, I just put my attachments on my gun, and I can switch them at any point that I want, and I think that's a great thing.
Yeah, there's some games that just try to be so unique that they end up not being fun.
Yeah. Oh, we're supposed to kill this boy?
Yeah.
Hey. Dang teleporting. I love this gun. Don't look. I didn't miss. Where's the big ball guy? Oh, there he is. How is he immune? What the heck?
Oh, it's because these things spawn.
Oh. They hadn't spawned in yet, and he was still immune.
Special ammo, don't mind if I do. What? I did pick up special ammo. What are you talking about? Okay, whatever.
Is the game lying to you again, Fizzy?
Yes, and I'm a little sad about it because my special ammo would be really good right about now.
Yeah. Well, we killed it, right?
Yes.
Woohoo! Sepix Prime cast a great shadow over our city. With its destruction, the fallen devils will grow weaker. But we must stay vigilant. The fallen are crafty, and they'll find ways to survive.
The fallen are crafty.
They're crafty. Oh my gosh, the loot that I keep getting is worse than the loot that I have.
Do you feel looted?
Yep. I feel lied to. Bamboozled.
First 343's lying to me, now Bungie's lying to me.
Well, I suppose in my defense, or in Bungie's defense, there's like an armor set and weapon set that I got that they kind of gave to me for free, and
so
everything's
free stuff, and now
really
you're complaining
good
about it, huh?
Yeah, because it's better than anything else that I'm getting. I'm actually playing the game and it's not rewarding me.
What the heck? 343,
have you gone to Helm?
Wait, what?
I'm gonna take you somewhere. I'm gonna see if there's stuff here.
Okay, for some reason I thought you said, have you gone to hell yet? And I'm like, no.
Have you gone to hell yet, Fizzy?
Have you gone to hell?
I have a very important question.
I mean, maybe one day, but not today.
Not today. But yeah, have you ever had, like, one of those moments where, like, you're like, I'm really enjoying this game, and everybody's like, that's the worst game in the franchise?
Yeah, Fallout 4, dude. Like, there's legitimately people that are like, there's legitimately people that say Fallout 4 is the worst Fallout in the entire franchise, and I'm like, guys, have you ever played Fallout 2? Like, it's not that bad.
It's not that bad. Okay, we can destroy you.
So that I don't know, it's interesting too because it just kind of depends on like the, like, I don't know, almost like the flavor of the day too, because like there's some games that like people hate now, but then like 10 years later they'll like totally love. So like,
yeah.
I remember so many people used to, like, believe it or not, like totally just rip on the original Star Wars Battlefront 2. They're like, yeah, it's so dumb, and like everyone who plays it is dumb, and like all this stuff, and like now everyone's like, oh, we wish that was the game. We wish they would bring that game back, and like all this stuff like that. And I'm like, okay, so you guys were totally not okay with it before, but now that, you know, we have crappier options, now you guys are all like, bring it back. I don't know, it's weird.
That is weird. Dude, why did they not like that game?
I don't
like,
know.
That's one of the best games.
I have no idea. I mean, it was like all like really like dumb reasons. Like, oh yeah, like the guns don't feel realistic, and like sprinting. Like that was back when people were like really getting like pissy over like sprinting in FPS games. They're like, oh man, there shouldn't be any sprinting in this game. Like what?
What?
Yeah,
it made it
weird.
So you could get across the map faster.
I know.
But yeah, Fizzy, do you see anything right here?
I'm not even over there right now. I'm still equipping what I got from her.
Okay.
Thingamajig. That one's way better.
Yeah. I really do enjoy this game and have fun, but like, yeah, sometimes it's like, crap, just going through my loot, which one's better? Reading the stats.
Reading the stats.
Yeah. I'm trying to... Yeah, I... For me, I think it was Fallout 4 because Fallout 4 was essentially my first Fallout game that I played all the way through. And I had a really good time with that.
Yeah, like, don't get me wrong, like, there's definitely things about Fallout 4 that could have been better. Like, I love the way that it plays, but, like, the story, I think, is the number one gripe that a lot of people have with it. Because the story could have, like, the story was okay, but it could have been way, like, there was just, like, some really big missed opportunities with the story. And so, like, I could definitely agree if people are like, yeah, like, that was the deal with the story. And I'm like, yeah, I can see that, but a lot of people, yeah. Man, they're just like legitimately like, this is the worst game ever made. And I'm like, no, it's not. But okay.
No, it's not. I'm trying to think, what is the worst game that I've ever played?
Oh, lost item.
Oh, yeah, do you see, like, a chest right here?
Yeah.
Yeah, open it.
Wait, is this just, like, free equipment?
Yeah, it's free equipment. Grab all of it.
Frick yeah. Go.
Oh, Lego Marvel Superheroes? Yeah, that one was pretty bad. That was super frustrating. I'm like, this game is made for children? I can't even figure out these puzzles. What the heck?
Oh, yeah. Freaking Lego Star Wars could be pretty unforgiving sometimes. No lie.
Yeah, I don't know what happened with the Lego games, dude. Like, I always felt like it was so simple when, like, I was playing, like, you know, the original ones. Like, the original trilogy and that sort of kind of stuff. But, like, I've tried to play some of the newer Lego games, and I'm like, what the freak is going on?
I know, I got the new Lego Star Wars not too long ago, and, like, oh my gosh, there is so much to do in that game that I got, like, a little overwhelmed. I was like, oh my gosh. Yeah, it was wild. Man, my dude looks sick now. Oh my gosh.
Ooh, nice.
Oh, hold on, I gotta switch a couple of my pants. I don't need this no more.
Okay, let me know when you're ready and we'll go play a game of Crucible and then we'll end the stream.
Right there, okay. Okay, let's do it.
Okay. Yeah. I'm trying to think what other games that I've played that I really have not enjoyed.
like have not enjoyed.
Yeah.
Oh man, I'm trying to think now too. Dark Souls 2, I hated that game. It's just like any of the games by that publisher are gonna be hard, but like
Yeah.
that game was just like unnecessarily brutally hard. I wasn't a big fan of Half-Life, believe it or not. Like everyone really likes Half-Life, especially like old school gamers, but I wasn't a big
Really?
fan.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean I could see the appeal, but like I just wasn't it wasn't it, it wasn't pulling me in. Wasn't for me. Trying to think.
So Far Cry 6. I love the world, and everything. Like, that's really cool. But the story and some of the coding is just terrible.
Oh, I've heard,
Like,
yeah.
there was literally a time where, like, you get in the back of a truck and, like, somebody's taking you someplace, and it's supposed to be like an in-game like cutscene, and the dude ran into like a military vehicle and they started shooting at us, but I couldn't get out of the back of the car, so I just
Oh.
got shot and killed.
Does that make that like that part of the game like basically unplayable?
Yeah, like it worked the next time I tried it, but it was like, really? And there's just like certain parts where I would try and do one thing, and it's like, no, you can't do that because that would like essentially wreck the story.
Oh, what?
And it's just like so cliche, and
Isn't Far Cry kind of like open world too?
yeah.
So like how could they do that while simultaneously be like, no, you can't do that, that'll ruin the story.
Yeah,
That
exactly. It's
doesn't make any sense at all. Okay.
Really weird. And like another thing, another gripe with it was just kind of like it like took me out of the story quite a bit when, like, for instance, you would like essentially like complete a mission and everybody would party and there would be like fireworks and stuff and you would get blacked out drunk, and I'm just sitting there like, but the story is that we're like essentially like a rebel force against the military. If we did this, they would know where we were and we'd get killed. Like, I know that it's a game and realism, it really isn't a thing all that much, but like, could you try it a little? It's kind of like, you know, Call of Duty 2, where it's just like, could you just try just a little bit?
Yeah. Okay, that makes more sense, Firewatch. Like, there's like some things you have to play like from end to end. You can't just do whatever you want.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Oh, that's right, Fire Squatch. Yeah, 2K, I suck at sports games. Like any sport game, I completely suck at it.
Oh, dude, I used to be so good at Madden back in the day.
You could probably still kick my trash.
I suck at football in real life, but
Control.
oh geez, I'm the feature guy this time? Oh boy.
What's up
I think it's
with
a
the helmet
I
wrap
know you can
paper
fight.
mache boy?
Can you hold
I don't
tension?
know. You know what I think is weird? Did you notice that Bungie for Destiny is doing like almost the same kinds of armor
You've
skins
captured
that
Zone C.
they did
Enemy
for the
claimed
Master Chief
Zone A.
collection recently?
Yeah, I thought that was really weird.
Yeah, I was like, Oh, this is a three shot. Oh, yes. Semi-automatic, let's go. I do love me some semi-auto weapons. Oh, ouch.
Oh, dang it.
Enemy claimed zone B.
Jeez, corn dog, Isha.
Oh, my bad.
No, but I really am one of those people that's
Enemy
like,
lead captured. Zone advantage is
with
yours.
sports, I'm like, I can go out and play, sports.
Ouch.
Like. Oh, crap. More people.
More people. I think my favorite sports game of all time is there was a hockey game that you could get for Super Nintendo. That was fire. Oh.
I mean, I'll play a sports game if it's like Mario or something like that.
Oh yeah, I feel you. Like, gotta do some Mario Tennis.
Yeah.
Low key for the Mario Golf is pretty fun as well.
Yeah. But more than anything, it's just kind of like, yeah, if I want to play sports, I'll just go outside. I want to play outside, games where, like,
gross.
Go touch grass, Fizzy.
LOL. Jokes on you, I've never touched grass.
Oh my gosh. Oh crap.
Oh my gosh. Man, this other team is just freaking saucing me.
Yeah, dude.
That shut them down. Oof. You captured Zone B. Zone advantage is yours. Zone C lost.
Oh, jeez, that bow. The Wrath of Bacon.
The Wrath of Bacon.
Do they really count as a sports game, though? I think they do. But it's not like a... You know, the good old Maddens.
Zone B lost. Power play. Enemy has your zones.
Oh, geez, hello. And I could do a racing game every now and again, but I usually laugh at those kind of games. Or get frustrated because of just the mechanics.
I'm so bad at racing games, like, honestly. You can ask Sullivan, like, Sullivan is like, Sullivan will crash in Mario Kart.
Really?
Yeah, like, Sullivan doesn't even play video games like that. Just wreck me.
Yeah. No, dude, I just hate the mechanics that are, like, the rubber banding. That,
oh, yeah.
Like, you'll have, like, a huge lead. And then all of a sudden, you know, they'll pop up next to you, and you're like, I could never go that fast.
Yeah. Power play. Keep the pressure on. Don't be locked.
Oh, no, Fizzy, did you leave?
Oh, I got booted for inactivity.
Feezy, what the heck, man?
I'm technically, well, I don't know if I should say this on the stream, but...
What?
I will text you later.
Okay.
No worries, it's not anything serious.
Okay. Well... While you're there, is there any other game type that you're like, I just don't play those?
I think. JRPGs, I'm not a super big fan of. I think the last JRPG I played was Final Fantasy IX.
Uh-huh.
So, but like, I've had a couple people try to get me into, like, Octopath Traveler, for example.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, I'm just not interested. Especially like anything with like turn-based combat. Like there is, I can count on two fingers the amount of turn-based combat games that I've actually enjoyed. But
Uh-huh.
it's not even for the combat, it's for the story, so turn-based combat just makes me angry.
Yeah.
I think one game, I think one type of game that I feel like it gets a little slept on just because there's not like a lot of good titles that comes out for it consistently is RTS games, so like real-time strategy.
Yeah.
I feel like real-time strategy is a mode that gets slept on that's actually really fun when you get a good title.
Zone A lost.
I guess
But
that's another one that I haven't ever played.
yeah, that's kind of the thing is like RTS, like you first of all, like I feel like people who grew up playing like tabletop games would be the most like interested in those because those are basically just like the video game versions of tabletop like strategy games kind of a thing.
Yeah.
So like if you haven't really played that, then it's probably gonna be like a little boring. But even
Three
then, like there's
eliminated.
some RTS games that like
Zone B
are so
captured. You
interesting and
have
play
advantage.
mechanically so well that it kind of gets past it. But the problem with that is that I feel like RTS games, they get few and far between when it comes to new title, like good titles, especially
Zone B
recently. Like one of my
lost.
favorite RTS franchises was used to be Dawn of War. It was like a 40K version of their tabletop strategy game, and like Dawn of War 3 was so insanely garbage. Like it was so bad. Like the way that like yeah, just like so like mechanically,
Zone
art
A captured.
style,
You have
story-wise, like it was just
advantage.
so bad that like I remember people bought it because like the hype train was real big for it. A lot of people bought it, and then like I think that was one of the largest runs for refunds in Steam
Zone
history.
B captured. That's a power play.
Really?
Because people played it for like 2 days, and then everyone and their brother went and refunded it.
Zone
Like I
B
did that.
lost.
I was part of that. I got it and was like, "Oh man, this was so much fun!" And then I played it for like
Zone
45
C
minutes and
lost.
was like, "Wow, this game is absolute
Your enemy
trash."
Oh my gosh.
Punish them for it.
So anyway,
Zone B captured.
that's kind of like the
You
chronic
have
thing is like either
advantage.
with RTS, you either get a very good game or a really bad game. There's no really in between.
Yeah.
Zone A
Yeah,
lost.
no, dude, I don't know. I just like being in charge of what I'm doing at all points in time. Like, first person is really my
Zone
jam.
B captured. You have zone advantage.
And really, like, pretty much all that I play.
1 minute left.
Like, I will play, Fortnite and stuff, which is third person. But like most of the time I get frustrated because I'm like my character's freaking blocking where I need to see.
Double down. Zone B lost. Your people
See, that's kind of the
victorious.
thing for me is like for it's like that's why like sometimes Halo is a little weird for me is because I like all the first person shooters I played
Zone's
had
bottom life, guardian.
the
Keep fighting.
for the
You'll
longest
get
time
it.
had the ability to play either third person or first person. And
Uh-huh.
so I've gotten a lot more used to it now because I played a lot more Halo recently than anything else, but sometimes the ability to not be able to do third person is a little weird. But I'm not saying it's bad.
No, you're saying it's terrible.
No.
How dare Halo not have a third person mode? Get it on it, Bungie. That's top
I'm
priority.
pretty sure that people would like be so pissed at 343 if they did that. Like it would be so bad. Like, you think they're mad now? If they did that, it would be game over.
Game over.
There's so many people that are just so invested in like that first person structure, you know? Like look at how many people got pissed that you could sprint in Halo 4, for example. Like they were like, "What the frick?" Or like even like reach like to the extent that you could, I guess. But which is why like I don't know if you've played Reach since they've redone the skulls for Reach, but like they put in the bandana skull for Reach, and it feels so crazy. You could just like infinitely sprint now.
What?
Yeah, you can just infinitely sprint because the bandana skull in that game gives you unlimited armor abilities, and technically sprinting is an armor ability in that game. So you could just sprint forever. And it's glorious.
That's crazy.
You could finish that. You could speedrun that game like, without even trying now.
That's kind of awesome fun.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun, not gonna lie.
Man. But, hey man, is there anything else you want to say before we head off?
Nope. Just everyone have fun. I hope everybody's having a good week, and we'll see you again on Thursday.
Yeah. We play some Halo. Maybe there'll be more Halo news we'll be able to talk about. Who knows?
I'm just hoping I can actually play Halo.
Yeah. Fingers crossed.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
But until then, have fun, but not too much fun, or else I'll be jealous. And once again, we'll see you on Thursday. Follow us on the Instagrams, YouTube, TikTok. We have tons of fun. Or at least I do. I don't know if you have fun with the posts.
I sure do.
Okay.
No, Zach, I have no fun. I hate it. I can't believe you would ever do anything on social media, ever.
Yeah, make it stop.
Jeez. You're on the clock app now? Blah, blah, blah. Blah.
I just turned around and there's a person with a chicken helmet.
Oh.
Okay, I'll leave. I'll see you guys later.